Tonight, our musicians, Valmar Jansen and Frank Jansen, her husband, are going to inspire us with music tonight. And we have some speakers who are going to share a bit of their story. And then we're going to have one of my favorite parts of the evening, which is hearing from each one of you who might want to share something after our speakers have given their few remarks. So tonight's event is sponsored by MS Bright Spots of Hope. We're a nonprofit that focuses on inspiration, education, and empowerment, very much like MyStrengthWellness, Lynsey's organization. The difference in our mission is that we focus on doing programs for people with MS and their families, programs that feature people with MS living positively with the disease. And we think that makes a big difference. We need to hear it from people with MS. So I would like to begin with our opening with Valmar Jensen, who is going to lead us in Lean on Me.
Thank you. We wanted to start the evening musically with something really fun and upbeat, because we want, part of being hopeful is having fun and enjoying oneself. Yes?
Yes.
So when I say lean on me, you're going to grab the hands of the people at the table with you. So lean on me means you're going to hold the hands of the people at the table. And we thought, well, if they're sitting at the table together, they probably know each other, so they will feel comfortable holding hands. So that when I say lean on me, you'll hold hands with the people at the table. When I say, when you're not strong, when I say the word strong, you're going to show me your muscles. And then do a WWE growl like this. When I say strong, 1, 2, 3, go, strong. I'll be your friend. Turn around and give somebody a low pound. Give somebody a low pound. I'll help you carry on. Here's the fun part. You're going to carry on. Put your hands in there and go, woo! Wonderful. When I say four, you say five. Four, four. When I say long, you say too short. Long, long. When I say need, you say elbow. And then touch your elbow. Need, need. So lean on me. Oh, hold somebody's hand. When you're not strong, I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on. Oh, look at the person at the table and say, that was pitiful.
That was pitiful.
Can we do better? Let's make some noise. 1, 2, 3, go. 4.
5.
It won't be long, but I'm going to need
elbow.
Somebody to lean on. All right. And it sounds like this. You know the song, right? So why don't you sing it with me? I love it. But first, make sure there's no food in your mouth. You don't want to do the Heimlich maneuver. So let's practice the moves with the lean on me. Here we go. Lean on me when you're not stronger. I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on. 4. It won't be long that I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong. I'll be your friend, low count. I'll help you carry on. 4. It won't be long that I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Please swallow your pride if there are things you need to borrow, for no one can fill those of your needs
that you won't let show. Lean on me when you're not stronger. I'll be your friend, oh pal. I'll help you carry on. For it won't be long that I'm gonna need somebody to lean. Call on me, brother. Just call on me, brother. If you need a hand, we all need somebody to lean on. You just might have a problem that you understand. We all need somebody to lean on. If there is a load you have to bear that you can't carry, that you can't carry, I'm right up the road. I'll share your load. If you just call me, lean on me. When you're not stronger, I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry some load. For it won't be long that I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Look at somebody and say, call me. Point to six more people. Call. Point to five more people. Call. Point to four more people. Call me. Three more. Call me. Two more. Call. Now one more person. Call me.
Way to get us started. All right. So now I'd like to first begin with our speakers. Oops. Our first speaker is Rosie. I met Rosie in person last night and I was so excited. Rosie is very busy with working 10 to 12 hour days at work and also busy with her family. But she's so full of energy. She's so full of life and she's proof that nothing is impossible if you try. Welcome, Rosie. And I want to tell you, you know, our speakers are not professional speakers. They're here to share their story. So let's give them a lot of love.
Thank you, Michelle. Hi everyone, and thank you for coming. My name is Rosangelica Bielbaso. Michelle asked me to share my journey with multiple sclerosis with you guys today. I had to fight to survive, literally all my life. Born at 21 weeks and weighing only 2 pounds, I had to fight just to be here. And look at me now, I'm a 28-year-old whose life has taught her to be a warrior. My journey with MS started in 2017 while getting ready for work one morning. I fainted. Working two jobs as a caregiver for people with developmental disabilities and at Victoria's Secret as a sales consultant, not a lingerie model. Add to that, my 3-hour-a-day bus commute. Talk about being tired. I thought exhaustion caused my fainting. A few months later, that same year, while working at a different job at a tortilla factory, my hands start to hurt and cramp from the repetitive motion of sealing the tortilla chip bags, or so I thought. Sorry, foggy brain, you know. A month later, while at home, I fainted again in the bathroom. I must have hit my head on something. I really don't remember. The blood coming from the top of my head and my cheekbone scared me. A CT scan in the emergency room showed nothing. A few months later, I started walking with a limp. Pretty funny. People at work told me I used to walk with a pep in my step. Yeah. While working at the Tatrina factory, I actually had a fainting episode. But I realized I also had seizures with it, witnessed by my coworkers. So my boss ends up sending me to the emergency room where they proceed to admit me. They run CT scans, MRIs, blood work, and finally, they do a spinal tap, also known as a lumbar puncture. You know, that speech thing that you get when you can't really talk, that happens sometimes too. The next morning, a neurologist comes into my hospital room and tells me I might have this thing called MS. I don't really know anything about MS. About a few months later, I start seeing Dr. Causey's then MS specialist, nurse practitioner, Lynsey Lakin. She tells me that my MRIs show these things called white matter lesions, and that my white matter lesions are my white matter lesions together with my physical findings and history are consistent with MS. At this point, I'm really scared. Not knowing anything about MS and what my future might hold terrified me. I also felt oddly relieved because now I know that all my symptoms were real and what we're up against. Ever since my diagnosis, I told myself that I'm not gonna allow myself to think negatively about what this challenge given to me will do. Rather than concern myself in what it will do, I remind myself what I can still do. I no longer take things like clear vision or walking for granted, because one day I may no longer be able to do them. I've learned to appreciate the autonomy of what this has given me. Because I know one day, well, I might no longer have it. Let's face it, it's not a walk in the park by any means. It's more like a roller coaster with ups and downs. Without the adrenaline, of course. Just like everyone else faced with any chronic health battle, I face my own and continue to have periodic seizures. It scares me, yeah. However, I'm very grateful that I have my family and coworkers and MyStrengthWellness. I'm glad Lynsey founded MyStrengthWellness because it's a group with people just like me, all you guys. It has given me a sense of hope, acceptance, and belonging. Although we are all a little different, we go through a lot of the same struggles. Some days I wake up feeling normal and others not so much. The hardest part is when you wake up and you can barely walk because you become quickly fatigued by doing nothing. It's the whole feeling like you have bricks on your feet thing. I just tell myself that I can do this. I put my favorite song on, put my earbuds in, and go about my day because I know it's just MS trying to get on my nerves again. The only way to fight death is life, and this is me deciding to live. Thank you.
Let's give her another round of applause. And now I'd like to introduce our second speaker, who I also met last night for the first time in person, talked to her on the phone. Her name is Barb, and Barb finds her family very important. She's a mother of two, grandmother of four, and one to be, and her husband, David, and they are big sources of strength for her. And she is a true example of the power of exercise as medication for MS. So please give me a warm welcome for Barb.
And I was thinking I probably didn't need the microphone because I pop out of that. You guys all hear me?
No, but we need you for the
Zoom. Okay.
All right, for the Zoom. Hi, you guys. My name is Barbara Titus, and I'm here to share my story about living with multiple sclerosis. So one day in 2005, I woke up. I couldn't feel my feet. I had no energy. I was walking like I was 8 months pregnant. So I went to see my regular doctor. He sent me for blood work, and then he referred me to a neurologist. And after several MRIs and that lumbar puncture, he diagnosed me with multiple sclerosis. So many thoughts filled my mind. What is MS? How's this going to change my life? I've always been healthy. Don't even wear reading glasses. My life's good. I'm married. I have two boys. We live here in Rancho, and I love my job as a registered dental assistant. All I knew is I needed to be strong for my family. I needed to educate myself. So I took classes and went to MS dinners. And what I enjoyed the most is meeting and talking to other people with MS. What I've learned from these classes and these dinners is although MS affects everybody differently, we still deal with a lot of the same struggles. Okay, my husband and I have been practicing yoga for years. Yoga benefits me physically. It helps me with balance, flexibility, and strength. It also benefits me emotionally. It helps me with stress management, focus, and anxiety. Shortly after being diagnosed with MS, I retired from the job I had been at for over 25 years. The muscle weakness, fatigue, and balance issues made it difficult for me to do my job as lead orthodontic assistant. I really loved helping to create that perfect smile. So shortly after I was diagnosed, not yet ready to retire. I needed to find something else I can do. Then out of the blue, the perfect job fell right into my hands. I got a call. It was my mother-in-law. Hey, Barb, what do you think about teaching CPR to my new mommies? So I started teaching CPR to the new mommies and recertifying the nurses in basic life support. I've been teaching classes for over 10 years and continue to teach classes today. My kids are grown. They're out on their own. My husband and I decided to become caregivers for my dad, 89 with Parkinson's. So in 2021, we moved into my childhood home to take care of him. We'd walk every morning at 8. He continued to fight. He never gave up. Even though being a caregiver was harder than I thought, I will always cherish that time we spent together. He died this past Christmas. He lived to be 91. I've got a lot of my motivation from him. I went to an MS dinner and I learned about this program, My Strength and Wellness program. So about 10 weeks or 10 months ago, I started this MS workout and yoga at Strive Physical Therapy. I don't remember. Okay. And we just finished our first balance boot camp class. So I've noticed so much improvement in my balance, my strength, my flexibility, and even my fatigue. I'm going to continue to take these classes so I can stay strong or even get stronger. I have MS, but MS does not have me.
See, I have that brain part too.
Wow. Thank you, Barb. That was very inspiring. Let's give her a round of applause. Well, now it's time for a little inspirational music again. So, Valmar, take it away.
This song is especially, I think I'm articulating what all of the caregivers and those who support us, all the family members, raise your hand, family members, support, look around the room. So this song is, I'm singing it for you. I'm articulating it for you because I'm sure I'm speaking and singing words that you feel. When you're weary, feeling small, when tears are in your eyes, I'll dry them all. I'm on your side. Oh, when times get rough and the friends just can't be found, like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down like a bridge over troubled water. Down and out, when you're on the street, when evening falls so hard, I will comfort you. I'll take your part. Oh, when darkness comes and pain is all around, like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down like a bridge over troubled water. I will lay me down. Sail on, silver girl, sail on by. Your time has come to shine. All your dreams are on their way. See how they shine. If you have MS, raise your hand. See how you shine. So, when you need a friend, I'm sailing right behind, like a bridge over troubled waters. I will ease your mind like a bridge over troubled water. Raise your hand, caregivers, supporters.
I will ease your mind. I will ease your mind.
laid me down like a bridge over troubled water. I will lay me down.
Let's give another round of applause. Well, we do have one more speaker, and I'm proud to introduce Rick, who I just met last evening. There he is, Rick. Rick is a native Californian, and as a loving husband, he's been married to Roxanne. They have two children and four grandchildren, and he offers proof that kindness can transform someone's dark moment into a blaze of light. Welcome, Rick.
I'm Rick Hess, my wife, Roxanne. My name's Rick Hess, and my wife, Roxanne, has multiple sclerosis. We've been married for 48 years. Both of us were born in Southern California, continue to live here this day. My wife, Roxanne, and I started our 5-decades-long journey with multiple sclerosis. During Rex's, I'll call her Rex now, sorry, Rex. First pregnancy with our daughter, while waiting in the sun at the Rose Bowl swap meet to open, her legs got very weak. I had to hold her up. She couldn't stand without me. Without my help. We blamed the pregnancy. A few years later, during her second pregnancy with our son on a trip to the LA Zoo, on a warm day, her legs suddenly became weak and she could not move her legs to walk. We blamed the pregnancy again. Within the next few months, her right eye developed optic neuritis. She went to our general practitioner and he sent us to an ophthalmologist. He diagnosed her problem, gave her some prednisone, and it cleared up. Well, later, while working, my wife started having numbness in her legs. Every time it got into spring and later, it'd go away in the winter. And this happened for a few years, and finally she's thinking she's nuts. So he diagnosed her problem and gave her the oral prednisone. The problem cleared up, but later while walking, my wife started getting numb in the spring. Working. I'm bad. I'm lost too. This happened for a couple years.
Sometimes.
Yeah, I know. Yes. Rex was sent to a neurosurgeon by her family doctor. We were told by the neurosurgeon he thought she had multiple sclerosis. She cried in his office, and I vowed to her that we would fight it together no matter what it takes. I take my vows very seriously. We drove home and looked in our medical book about multiple sclerosis and the effects it has on your body and mind. It scared her to death. That night in bed, I woke up to hear her sobbing. I pulled her to my shoulder and let her cry. A neurologist performed a lumbar puncture on her. The results were negative. We asked, if it is multiple sclerosis, what do we do? The neurologist told us my wife could not take hot showers and no hot tubs. That was her treatment. RexCan became a peer counselor for those that had MS. One woman she counseled suggested she try another neurologist at Loma Linda Hospital. The neurologist at Loma Linda performed a normal test, walking, balance, reflexes. Not long after the visit, the doctor was able to procure an appointment for an MRI. During the MRI, Rex became claustrophobic twice. The text came and got me, told me to take all metal off my person and put on a gown. I went into the MRI room and I was set in a chair and had my hand on her leg to help calm her. The tech turned to me and said, "Do not get out of the chair." And I asked why. Response was, "If you do that, the chair will slam against the MRI." The chair's frame was melted. The MRI showed lesions consistent with a multiple sclerosis in her brain. For many years, we were told that 450,000 people in the United States had multiple sclerosis. The years went by and the numbers were always the same, 450,000. The last few years, the numbers increased to 1.5 million. And that's still small. This is still a smaller number of people that actually have multiple sclerosis. There's more. I personally believe more money was finally given to study and find out what would help stabilize and find a cure because of the climbing number of cases. The good news is that people with multiple sclerosis have more new medicines to combat the effects that multiple sclerosis brings to the table. My wife and I went from no hot showers and stay out of hot tubs to having more choices available to us. Anything from steroids, very strong steroids, to stock exacerbations and multiple sclerosis. Slow down the multiple sclerosis, excuse me. Help people lead a more normal life and also be happier for themselves and the ones they love. Rex's physical therapy she has had has helped her balance, taught her to walk properly, and to be able to use her hands in everyday life. She has not fallen while walking in a long time, but therapy has done wonders to help her with everyday activities. Care partners, read as much as you can to learn about your own health. Care partners have a big role to fill. Some, if not all, will need someone that is trustworthy to relieve them, to help give the care partners time to themselves away from their daily duties. My wife and I have been learning about multiple sclerosis for 5 decades. During these years, I do have my days that are hard, depending on what is happening to Rex that day. I take my marriage vows very serious in sickness and health till death do us part. I have never given thought to not caring for her the rest of my life and never will. My advice to care partners is to find all you can about multiple sclerosis. Being a care partner and about your own health. Observation is a great key for me. I watch Rex to see how her stride and posture are like in the mornings and throughout the day. Observing helps me see how she is doing that day. Of course, most of the time, she doesn't know I'm observing her most of the time, basically. It is a must to show your care partner the same love and affection that you have always have done. But in a moment, things will call you into being a care partner. Role again. I have been changing roles for years without knowing it. Care partners will always plan ahead as much as you can. If a wheelchair, walker, or scooter is needed fast, you will have the tools ready to be used by getting them early. One of the most important things I have is a loving, caring multiple sclerosis specialist who will listen to you, give you the time to ask questions, and the time to answer all of your questions. My wife and I are lucky to have the right specialist that is all of these. Remember, more research is being put into multiple sclerosis. This, I think, is great news for those with it and their care partners. Thank you for listening to my words, and I hope this will help you.
What a wonderful message. Let's give a hand to Rick. Let's give a hand to each one of those care partners. Just love that. So many, many pieces of good advice there. Lots of education, lots of support, finding other people. I love that about the observation. I knew I was being watched all the time too. So now I'd like to ask Lynsey to join me.
And I'm not sure how this is going to work, Lindsay, but I think you're supposed to turn that on. Okay, except the people in the audience won't hear.
So, isn't that funny?
It's.
She can borrow yours. No. Could I borrow yours? And yeah, then.
You just can't walk around with it.
I'll come to that one.
That's fine. Perfect. Yeah, I'm just coming over there.
Oh, I heard too.
Okay, so this is where, to me, one of the funnest parts of this evening is hearing from you. And there's a couple of you who, when we sent out the registration form, we'd asked if you'd like to share. And so I do have a couple of volunteers. And the first one I'd like to hear from is Sarah. Sarah Huizeda. Okay, Lynsey, you want to go back to Sarah? Sarah has a little bit of hope that she'd like to share. Wait for the mic, please, so that people on Zoom can see you and hear you.
That's why I don't do that, guys.
I don't really remember what I said, but I, MS is a bummer, but it's given me like a lot of opportunity to find my voice in a lot of ways. So I advocate and I participate in walking MS and just, I find joy in like the things that it has brought me. So
thank you for sharing that. To me, the beauty of Sarah's message is the point of connection, right? That we need that. We need to be advocates for one another. Thank you, Sarah, for that wonderful tidbit. I'd like to also hear from Amanda. Amanda, if you're here. Amanda had several tidbits, but she'd like to just pick out one tonight and share it with us.
Okay. Hello. I was like, they didn't contact me, so maybe I'm not speaking. Okay. I'm Amanda. I'm local to Rancho Cucamonga. I now live in Corona. I've had multiple sclerosis since 2000. I was diagnosed at the age of 19 in 2006. So I've had it for 17 years. I have two small children, a 6 and an 8-year-old. So I just want to give hope to anyone who is starting off young. You know, there is a life after your diagnosis, and I'm living proof. And yeah, I love to connect with people. So if anyone wants to chit chat after, I'd love to.
Thank you, Amanda.
what an important message to hear, that you can't have children after diagnosis of MS. And when I was diagnosed at the age of 25, my husband and I were just thinking of starting a family, and I asked my doctor. And back then, the advice wasn't always 100% correct. But my doctor said, you have to consider a child physically, psychologically, financially, emotionally, all that entails. And yes, we decided to have two children. How about Katrina? Would you like to share just a word or two?
A word or two?
Thank you, Katrina.
I often tell my groups that hope is something that we do discuss, and hanging on to positive experiences. We all have to know that when we're first diagnosed and when we're in the downs of MS, it's hard. But we have to know that things get better. It looks brighter. We can have children. We can go to school. We can change our careers. MS isn't the sentence it was 50 years ago. And I know, being diagnosed in 2003, MS has changed even since I've been diagnosed. Your life doesn't end. It has differences. Everybody's life has differences. So we have to be positive.
Absolutely. Thank you, Katrina. And I think you and Rick both pointed out a very, very important part. And that is the difference today that we have now 29 medications to treat multiple sclerosis. When I was diagnosed, there were zero. And so the world of MS has changed tremendously. And we have so many tools and resources. So we can't reject those tools and resources when they're offered to us. I walk with a crutch, two crutches. I have braces on my legs. They keep me moving. There was a time in my life where a 10-year period of time, I was in a scooter nearly full time. And I regained my mobility with exercise and God's blessing and no exacerbations. And so I'm living proof that you can overcome and you can continue to strive and you can get better. So someone else who would like to share, please. Okay. Please say your name.
Mary. My name is Mary Kay Harris, and since meeting Lynsey, she's just a bright spark in my life. And I also want to say, I failed to exercise during December and January, and I was beginning to pay the price for that. And so I got my Fanny back to the YMCA and hopped in the swimming pool. And I've been doing laps two days this week. And my legs already feel better. My hips already feel better. So I can't say enough about exercise. It's very important.
Thank you. Hey, Tom. And I love the honesty there, right? We all fall off the wagon sometimes. We forget to get our bodies up and move, whether we have MS or not, right? We're very sedentary. You know, sitting is the new smoking, right? So we need to move our bodies, and we can do it multiple ways. And swimming is a fabulous way to exercise, even just moving in the water. The pool, we're staying at a hotel nearby that had an indoor pool, and I used the pool today, and it was fabulous. So let's take advantage of those resources, right? Okay. Someone else. I know you're out there. Don't be shy. All right. There we go.
Hi, my name is Lillian, and my daughter here, Elena, was diagnosed in 2018. For the longest time, from the time she was a teenager, she was always falling. And I would tell her, Elena, you know, you need to be, don't be so clumsy, watch where you're walking, you know. Mom, I try, you know. And I said, oh, I don't know what I'm gonna do about you. So as time went on, she got married, and she still was not diagnosed at that time. She had her beautiful son, and as her caregiver, the three of us live together. And she is a fantastic mother. Even when she's feeling the worst, that she's in bed for days, she always makes time for her son.
Thank you.
And, but in turn, I want to share the fact that my grandson that just turned 11, he loves his mother so much. Every single day, he talks to her, and the first thing is, Mom, how do you feel? Mom, what can I do? Do you want me to massage your legs? Do you want me to do this to you? Do you need the heating pad? He's always wanting to know, what can I do to help my mom?
Thank you, Lily. And that is a beautiful message of hope.
Yes.
And your message of the importance of family. We couldn't do it without the family. Thank you again. I think we have someone over here, Lindsay. Someone over here. That's okay. Crying is all right.
I was diagnosed.
Your name?
Lisa, sorry. I started having weird symptoms. My oldest daughter, and I have a younger daughter that's 23, and they'd be like, Mom, do you have Alzheimer's starting? Do you have dementia? What's going on with you? I worked at a really busy staffing agency, and I started having what we found out were absence seizures. So I stopped working, and that was really hard. But I did meet Lindsay, and she's been amazing. Had my lumbar puncture. That was the worst experience of my life because I have my fluid doesn't come out. So they poked, and but they found lesions in my brain. But then I have what they all say I'm an interesting case, is I have syringomyelia and hydromyelia as well. I've had many flare-ups over the years. Depression. No one talks about that. No one understands. You know, it's not a tired where you just, oh, you go to bed earlier, you just wake up later. It's, no, you're tired and you can't explain it, you know.
Lisa, that sums up what so many of us have been through.
Yeah.
And so many of us are still going through. Depression is a common symptom of MS. In fact, it's not a reaction to the illness. It can often be a symptom of the illness.
Yeah.
And the point is, there's treatment, and we have our MS community here. Yeah. Thank you for sharing, Lisa. Thank you so much. It's hard sometimes when we have something hard to share. Thank you for having the courage. Someone else. I think we have time for one more person. Somebody? No?
There's 14 minutes left, though.
Oh, yes, but we have other announcements. We're not done yet. Thank you for keeping us on time. It's always important. Will you get my paper from over there? Okay, so I'm going to move on to the next part of our program with that prompt there. Oh, I think I need the last page. Is there one more page? Oh, here it is. There we go. Okay. So at this point, we're not done yet, but I would like to thank all of the sponsors again tonight and really recognize them, because again, we could not do a program like this, providing you with the hope and the inspiration without our sponsors. Biogen, Bristol-Myers Squibb, Alexion, Strive, Genentech, EMD Serono. Let's give them a big round. I'd also like to thank all the volunteers and also Lynsey and Jennifer. Jennifer, where are you? Would you please stand? I didn't have a chance to really, I know at the beginning I recognized Jennifer, but it was kind of brief. Jennifer is a family nurse practitioner, and she has been working with Lynsey, and she's, I guess, did a mentorship with Lynsey, and she has been helping with My Strength Wellness, and I just like to recognize her for all she's done. Thank you. I'd like to take a moment to ask. We do have the envelopes on the table, or no? Do we have envelopes on the table? Did we remember that?
No.
Okay. Envelopes for the gift from the heart. All right. So we will go with plan B. So let's pass out the evaluations, please. So one of the things that's very important to us is always that we're doing a good job, that we're meeting your needs. We set certain goals for these events, and we appreciate your evaluation of tonight's program. So there's pens on the table. My husband's going to be passing out, and other volunteers. We're not done yet, but I want to give you a chance to have a chance to think about those how you would like to evaluate tonight's program. Just circle at the top if you have MS. If you don't have MS, you'll circle the no, but you'll still fill out an evaluation. I'd like to give you a chance to give from the heart tonight. As I mentioned, we have sponsors, but if you'd like to make a donation tonight, we do have a master envelope that will be happy to take a check or cash if you have it with you, whatever amount you have. Or you can donate online. We do accept credit cards online at MS Bright Spots of Hope. So we would be happy to accept a donation that way. Did you want to say something?
I do.
And then
I just want to thank, we had so much help tonight. So I just express my appreciation of all the volunteers. So everyone who volunteered, you know who you are. Come on up, please. Just stand in the line. I'm not going to embarrass you. I just want you guys to stand up here. Yeah. Jennifer, you too. Yeah, so look at all this help. Just thank you guys. I'll go over here so I can see you. but I just want to thank you guys for your help, for being here. You guys volunteer your time. Victor, you're supposed to stand, but I know you're still working. but just so grateful, just because it means so much. It meant so much for everyone here. It made it happen so smoothly. And so so if we can give them a round of applause too, just for helping. And I also just want to just stay there because I have a little something for you, and I don't have enough hands. but I also just want to especially recognize Jennifer, which not only did she donate her time to do so much just for making the place beautiful and picking out everything, but just for her passion for helping the MS community. Jennifer's been such a huge help for over the years. And so just want to especially just give her recognition. So if we can give her a round of applause. And Valimar Jansen, just thank you so much for being here. So Valimar, she travels all over the world. You'll see in her program, this is a very, very short bio compared to what her true bio is. And as I was trying to summarize, I was like, oh my gosh, I'm just gonna say she's traveled globally and been in movies and made albums, but she's just incredible. And it truly is a blessing that she could be here tonight. It just truly was divine that you said yes, and just so inspiring. It's humbling and such a blessing that you're here. So thank you. If we could give her a round of applause. She's so amazing tonight. Oh, yes, and her husband as well. Yes, oh my goodness. Thank you so much. You're so wonderful as well. I guess when I say Valimar, including both of you. And Michelle Keating and your husband, Rick, thank you guys for being here, for making an appointment.
I'm Lynsey from all her work.
Okay, so you have some gifts you're passing out. I'm going to ask Rick, would you check and see if you could see a light switch for this room, perhaps? Take a quick peek. I see on the one wall near the closets. I don't know if that's a light switch. Ah, that's good. Ah, very nice. That's perfect. Okay. And you could turn it down one more in just a moment. Not yet. Okay. So there are flowers at your table, as you can see in a vase, at least at most of the tables. If you have been diagnosed the most recently at your table, or if your birthday is closest to February 10th, you may take the flowers home. So either you can decide at your table, do you want it to be if your birthday's close to February or the one who's most newly diagnosed at your table? Okay, as we close, let me have your attention for one more minute. As we get ready to close tonight's program, I want to share a message with you. Hope is being able to see there is light despite the darkness. Each of us have the light of God in us and shine for all. So you'll notice on your table, there are candles, battery operated candles. Go ahead and turn your candle on. Twist it to turn your candle on. As we join in a final song, okay? As we join in our final song,
every human on earth is given the spark of life, the light of life. So, especially when you're feeling down, remember that you still have a light inside of you. Yes?
Yes.
If you believe it, say yes.
Yes.
I have a light. We each have a light of life while we're alive. So we're called to offer this light to others when things get dark. So I want you to, when I say lift it high, like set it high on a hill, I want you to lift your light up, okay? So right now, just hold it close to your heart. There we go. And the song sounds like this. You might know it. And if you know it, sing it with me. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let me sing.
This little light of mine.
Yes.
I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine. Let it shine. Let it shine.
So let's move our lights from right to left.
This little light of mine.
Put it up.
Set it high up on a hill. I'm gonna let it shine.
Do it again.
Set it high up on a hill. I'm gonna let it shine. Set it high up on a hill. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine. Let it shine. Let it shine.
Last time. This little light line. Raise your voices.
This little light.
Like to make a donation, I've already talked about that. I have a brown manila envelope, and if anybody wants to come up and give a donation, you can feel free to do so. I'll hold the envelope up here. And mostly, I just like to again say thank you for coming out tonight. I hope it was a memorable evening for you. And did we do okay on time, sir? Check it out. I need him to come to all my events.
Thank you
to all our guests at home, and good night.